The chairman of the Balawaristan National Front, BNF, Abdul Hamid Khan, has said that the oppressed people of Gilgit Baltistan will vote in favor of joining India as they are fed up with Pakistan's colonial rule.
There are only two options. Either you can vote to India or you can vote to Pakistan. And after the long 69 years experience, we the people of Gilgit Baltistan, we are living under the durance of Pakistan, under the occupation of Pakistan. And we live like in a prison of 72,000 square miles. And by keeping that in our mind, if we have only two options, we will not give our vote to Pakistan. We will vote for India.
Criticizing Islamabad for violating the UNCIP resolution and for falsely framing political activists, religious persons and students of Gilgit Baltistan under the controversial Anti-Terrorist Act of Schedule 4, Khan said, access to justice is denied because there is no legal, constitutional, high court or supreme court in the region. He claimed that the judicial system of Gilgit Baltistan is under Pakistan and its armed forces' firm control.
Pakistan is the first country which violated UN resolutions, and then it demands for UN resolution. If you are demanding UN resolution, first you perform yourself, your obligation, you withdraw your forces from the area, and then you can ask the United Nations to tell the India to withdraw its bulk of its forces from that area. But Pakistan is violating the rights of the people of Afghanistan. You see, we are not allowed to free speech, we are not allowed to free work in our area. Our area, if you say anything, you will be detained under the terrorist law, you can be detained under the sedition law, you can be detained under the Schedule 4, now they have imposed Schedule 4 after the CPEC, and the people have no freedom. And the people of Gilgit have no right to access the justice system.
The lives, properties and freedom of the people is under serious threat due to Pakistan and China's joint conspiracy to strengthen their occupation under the garb of the China-Pakistan Economic Corridor, CPEC. The corridor, which starts in China's Xinjiang province, enters Pakistan via Gilgit Baltistan.
The Gilgit Baltistan is the first victim, you can say. I don't use the word of area, it's the first victim of CPEC. Because the Chinese government, they did not talk with the representative, any so-called representative, the GBLA or its governor or its chief minister, they didn't take them into account. Before this CPEC agreement was done, this was done during the PP, Pakistan People's Party government, Zardari, you know, he is Mr. 10% or Mr. 20%, he takes his own share. And after that, the whole Pakistan army is backing CPEC because they have got a lot of dollars. They put the dollars in their pocket, and that's why they are defending the CPEC. And nobody in Pakistan was consulted before this CPEC and even after CPEC. And that's why we are totally against this CPEC. If you are doing some development or some good thing to the people of Pakistan, why you don't talk to them? Without taking them into confidence, and it's violation of their rights, it's violation of UNCIP resolution, it's even violation of Pakistani constitution, if it's a violation of all the norms of international law.
People from across Pakistan and China are now settling in Gilgit Baltistan. As in 1974, the government of Pakistan abolished state-subject rule in the region. In an utterly disgraceful move to ensure its own colonial control over Gilgit Baltistan, Pakistan has deployed its citizens in all departments, including administration, police and judiciary. Abdul Hamid calls it a deliberate attempt by Pakistan to grab the resources of Gilgit Baltistan by making the indigenous people into minority.
In the whole Jammu and Kashmir, including Ladakh and Gilgit Baltistan, Maharaja of Jammu and Kashmir, he imposed state subject rule in 1927 to protect the people, their history and their culture and their resources, their land, from outsider invasion. He imposed that a good law in 1927. But on the other side, the India is, I think, respecting their state subject rule. No Indian citizen from other state, they can buy any land in Jammu and Kashmir, and they cannot acquire any employment, permit employment there, and their rights are protected. But on the other side, in Gilgit Baltistan, this law is totally violated. The Pakistan is sending on a daily basis its own citizen, and even Afghans, Indians, the terrorist patrons, to settle in Gilgit Baltistan by violating state subject rule. And the people have no place to go to challenge this law. Either you can pick the gun someday and you do whatever the other people of the world they do. Otherwise, Pakistanis are not democratic loving people. They don't listen to the people's voice.
People in Gilgit Baltistan are living under constant fear as Pakistan and China continue to indulge in violating all international norms by exploiting their resources and land. A large number of political workers in Gilgit Baltistan are facing death sentences in fake cases without the right to appeal in any High Court and Supreme Court. Those who raise their voice against the forceful occupation are being crushed.